You do understand. You understand then that you are being. You understand that you are being discriminated against.
Yes.
Do you understand that you're being
discrimination downright?
Do you are? Do you understand that you aren't liking what you're having?
Yes.
You need to know that that's not important to me. What's important to me is every time you argue, you prove that what I said about you is true. That you're argumentative, that you're belligerent, that you're uncooperative, that you're uncivilized, that you don't follow the rules, that you want to have things your own way, that you are accustomed to using power, and that you don't understand.
A lot of people are totally unaware that discrimination goes on as much as it does.
Okay, what I want to know what happens when it happens. When it happened to you the last time, what
happened? Wait.
No.
You don't have to answer that question.
Yes, you do. Say what you
no,
want to say.
You don't have to answer that question.
When it happens out there in the real world, people make a stand. It's against the law and people make a stand. Now I'm making a stand. Enough.
Don't listen to her.
I understand what you're doing. I'm just saying I don't understand why. I've spent the morning with these people and none of them are racists.
Just because my skin isn't black. I mean, I'm you probably noticed, a little bit tubby. I've been discriminated. Yeah, I am. I've been discriminated with that all my life. I still put up with it.
Yeah.
Face it. I go into shops and see a nice shirt. Oh dear, they don't do my size. Oh well, I'll have to put up with it, won't I?
You can lose your tubby.
Mm.
But you can't change the colour of your skin.
Unfortunately, there's a small minority that will use the word racism. They bandy it around when it's not. Let's use the word political correctness. You're not allowed to use the word gollywog anymore. It's not offensive to you.
I don't fuck
bar black shit. What's that about?
What's strange is that you've got the blue-eyed people actually sort of arguing that racism isn't a problem.
Yeah, the blue-eyed people are defending the system. They're saying, you know, we all have to suffer. It's difficult for all of us. You know, the guy's saying, well, I can't get the right size shirts. You know, this kind of thing. And they're still not recognising the difference in the scale of what's being experienced by minority groups as opposed to what most people in society are putting up with, which are minor inconveniences by comparison.
So I'm sensing, do people really understand what is racism? The group of the blue eyes are white people. They're living in their world. So we're asking them to live in a world of what it's like to be black or Asian, which is quite difficult to do in 2 hours. So in their minds it's like, well, racism doesn't exist because it doesn't exist to them.
Jane Elliott has carried out her controversial exercise all over the world. But here in Britain, she's met stubborn resistance.
I'm not going with all this crap you're putting out, sorry.
That's up to you.
When I came here, racism, oppression was wrong. When I leave here, I will still think that.
In the blue-eyed group, the all-white volunteers are refusing to accept the exercise has anything to teach them. While the majority brown-eyed group are watching on, reluctant to speak out.
Do you think this is going to plan? Is this how it's supposed to be?
I don't think it's going quite according to plan, in the sense that usually by this point you'd expect the blue eyes to be more crestfallen and you might expect the brown eyes to be getting more energised about criticising them.
The browns aren't joining in a lot though, are they?
No. And I think that probably represents which country you're doing this exercise in. Whereas America, there is a strong divide, or Australia or South Africa. And this country, it's more subtle. So even though they may have an opinion, they're sort of keeping it quiet to themselves.
I am a mum who's white, grandma who's white, my auntie who's white, my cousin who's white. I mean, my family is white. So the only thing that isn't white is my appearance, in terms of my mannerisms and everything else, so I play the game.
Jane Elliott now introduces a setup designed to force any reluctant volunteers to finally step into the fray.
You, stand up here beside me. You, right here. I wanted you, nice blue-eyed white people, to find out how it feels to be on the receiving end of that which we allow to be handed out to whole groups of people every day. You don't live what she lives with.
And you can't argue with somebody's experience.
No.
If you don't see the other person's reality, then, and you don't face that reality, you're almost part of the problem because you don't see any reason for change it. Change what? Change what?
in the UK, the racism, it's very subtle. It's very subtle.
Her child learns something like this every time he walks down the goddamn street.
Stop and search.
And in the United States of America,
any kid stop and search because there's a knife problem at the moment.
Eight times
any
more
child.
Likely to be stopped and searched as a black boy.
Yeah, but you keep saying statistics. I'm sorry.
That's how it is.
Everywhere, all teenagers out of knives.
The statistics show
the police will stop them and look for knives. It doesn't
matter
what color.
Eight times more likely to be stopped and searched.
One of my favorite friends is a local Bobby on.
You're not hearing me.
Denying the facts.
You feel you're unique.
And now
unique.
You're getting defensive.
You are not unique.
You're still not hearing the point. You're not hearing
the point. I'm totally hearing the point. What I'd like to hear more is what you propose to do to actually change all this.
Hold on a minute.
Let's get on to that later. How are we going to change it?
Oh, good. I'm so glad you asked that. I'm so glad you asked that.
I'm bored with this bit now. I'm ready for a tea break. I want to move on.
What you're doing is blaming the victim.
What victim?
What you're doing is blaming the victim. You're saying to her, what are you going
what
to do
are you
to change this?
Gonna do?
She doesn't have the power to change this.
I just said, what are we?
No, you did not.
No,
what
I'm
did
sorry,
she say?
You weren't listening.
What's actually going on here?
This is a lot what happens in society, where people are just in so much denial that they feel, well, you sort it out, it's your problem, but it's actually all of our problem.
I think the people who are actually learning a lot here is the people in the brown group, because they're learning about how impenetrable this is for white people, for majority of people, that they cannot get it, they cannot get this difference of perspective. It's really tough for them. They either don't want to accept there is discrimination, or they don't see the discrimination, or they don't understand what it is when they do see it.
As the disagreement escalates, one of the more cautious volunteers finally steps forward.
I don't think we are in denial. I think you want us desperately to be in denial.
Pearl! Stump. I have a daughter that lives, not with me, obviously, but she lives in a very middle-class area. A very rural area, and she's the only non-white in her school. I will not go and pick her up from school because of my belief of other parents' perceptions of my daughter because her father looks like I do. Now, you can frown as if to say, well, why? But the bottom line is, after 34 years of my life in this country, that's how I feel.
Now
another reality of it, and ask any of my friends, is I talk in terms of I play the game. Okay? If you speak to me on the phone, you will have zero idea of what I look like. You either conform, in which case you get an easy life, or you fight against it and you'll end up criminalized, outcast, and removed from the situation.
But Marvin, what you've said, I agree with, but it's not colour. You could be a skinhead and not want to pick your kid up from school.
The skinhead can let his hair grow. I'm talking wholly and exclusively based on the colour of my skin. Nothing else. Just to qualify the thing about the school, part of the reason I don't go to the school is because, I mean, I'm mixed race, so I'm only half caste. My daughter has got a white mother, which means she's even lighter than me. Therefore, I believe that most, if not all, of the people at that school think she's white. If I turn up, then the children will see a different...
And treat her differently. And again, it's
not necessarily because these kids are ignorant, it's because these kids live in an environment that's wholly of white people. I chose to play the game.
That's right.
That's it.
We have to play the game. There is this game we have to play to get by.
White people play the game as well. My ex-husband, for example, is in the sporting environment. He's taking on top quality customers, the RAF, people like that. But he conforms. He has to wear a business suit. He has to wear a tie. He has to speak beautifully. He has his short back and side haircut. He looks immaculately groomed. He's actually a rugby player from way back. He's happy wearing sloppy old jumpers.
Is he white?
He used to have his hair longer.
Is he white?
We have to conform as well.
Is he white?
That's not so, conforming.
So, you're talking about conforming. He would conform to pick up my daughter from her school. He would not turn up looking like a scruff bag with long hair, bad clothes, bad breath, unwashed, bad shoes.
Isn't that pride, though?
No. It's exactly the same. You're talking about your school environment with your daughter, my school environment with my daughter.
We all agree that it's not the same.
It's not the same. It's not the same.
But it is. Sorry.
Yes.
Maybe
yes,
to a less degree.
Let's agree. Let's agree to disagree.
But there was the assumption that racism is only particular for people who are black. And I don't actually agree with that. I think there's racism for white people just as much. I've been in the situation many times where I've had remarks made about my person, the fact that I'm white, that I'm blonde, that I'm getting old or whatever. I've come across just as much discrimination in my life as possibly many black people have.
But it's interesting now that the brown eye group are actually talking up. You know, the blue eyes were obviously saying, this is where I stand, I don't agree with this. And the brown eyes say, no, listen, these are the experiences that we have had, and making relation to what people are actually saying in the blue eyes.
So what do you think this tells us then about discrimination in Britain?
In Britain, you've got an establishment with power. And that establishment, the people who are part of it, the rules, the laws that we have, are things that people take for granted as being fair. But they privilege a certain set of people more than everybody else. So it's not that we have one particular racial group that everybody's racist against. It's that there are many minority groups, all of which are disadvantaged by this system of power.
But you might walk away from this and say the white people in the blue-eyed group are just in denial.
I totally agree, because there's a sense of, like, well, we're not racist, and racism doesn't happen. Because the discourse now is that people are feeling, whether you're black, white, Asian, everyone feels they're being discriminated against. But what people are failing to recognise is the issue of power. And this is what Jane is trying to present, but they're not actually quite getting that right now.
But Jane Elliott is undeterred, and the segregation of the two groups continues during the food break.
Well, I'm getting drawn into something that I don't want to argue about, because I don't want to see other people abused.
But the thing
you
is,
are saying that just because you are black, only black people experience racism. I grew up in a country full of people where there weren't any white people. I understand racism just like you understand racism. I don't have to be black to understand what it feels like to be a black person. You don't have to be white to, you can still empathise with people. She wanted people to understand what black people were going through, but she didn't want to understand what anybody else was going through. I hate people putting other people down. It's wrong, and I don't like it. You know, it's not about being black or white to me, and I think it was a bigger issue. It wasn't just about... She made it too simple. She was separating us. There were black people, there were white people, and that was, as far as she can say, that's all it was.
Once you start thinking, oh, everybody's looking at me, I'm different. Everybody's got it in
now,
me.
Are they? Nearly as many of them as us. So they're not different.
But in my class, one third of my class are black children. Then I've got a bunch of half-caste children. I've got one little girl who's stunningly beautiful. She fell over, scraped all her face. I admit I was slightly surprised that where she scraped all her face, it's all pink underneath. Right? Did I expect it to be black? I don't know.